Okay, main thing we will cover here, our order status. In the my accounts, I have a tab in my orders. Here I just fetch order status, order total, and a dummy image with a date of order. That is table coming from here, simply orders table. Okay, and two anchor tag, order detail, empty page. Okay, and second is track order. Tag order here is again order ID, total, and order status, same from this table. Actually this is a static, we will make it by process order. Like we already I have a pending dispatch process shift deliver, and according to this we have a this type of status in our database. So for that we will go to our track.blade.php, which we are tracking here. Here is a you can say if third step is already done, then make it done and you will see it's done. So we need to make it dynamically. For that I will do inside directory of my account I will create a steps. Okay, and in here I will create my pending dot php, just simple php, no need to blade. Okay, and second we will say dispatch one, copy this, save it. Okay, small d is okay, and next one process. Okay, so we will say here is process small p. Okay, and next one is shift, so we will say shift, and last one is deliver and put as deliver inside. Now here you will call include function according to your status. So what is the status? Here my status, we will say if my status equal to pending, so we will call here pending one. Okay, include my count directory name steps dot pending. Okay, yes, pending. Refresh is nothing because I have not here pending, so let me this one make it pending. Just manually you will make it pending. Okay, refresh my order. Here is no, this was not my one. So which one? Yeah, I think this one, sorry, I put wrong update. Okay, refresh my order, here is pending track. Okay, you might not found. Okay, I spelling mistake here, account. Okay, that's silly mistake. Refresh here, you can see. Now you need to just change the status inside your steps. So for that go to your steps, open is deliver, so you will say done for deliver, and dispatch only front of done dispatch is to do, that's fine. And pending here to do process here done, that's fine. Shift to do done, yes, fine. Now it's pending, that's fine. Now go to your account again. Check shift 1 track order. Okay, now you have to put other if else also according to this one. So for that you will say else at the rate else with if it is second one is I already name it here dispatch second one. You can see here dispatch. Let me check again my other status. Yeah, second one dispatch. Okay, so we will check here if second status equal to your dispatch, then we will say include my account dot steps dot dispatch. Okay, everything is okay. Now just copy this, put it 2-3 times according to your status. Okay, next one is processed. Just put here processed. Okay, and next one is shipped. Shipped. Okay, and last one is deliver. So here is deliver. Delivered. That's fine. Now go to panel, refresh. Okay, I have a syntax error. Okay, else if. Okay, it's not like this, it's like this. Not at the rate, no space. Okay, save it. Yeah, now stated is shipped. Okay, let me check. Okay, it's wrong because S is capital. Oh, it's shipped. Now check any other. Let me log out. Login with any other one. Yes. Go to my account. Shipped. It's already shipped. Okay, it's shipping. No, we need to make it shipped. Okay, that's why we are doing here. Okay, now log out and check any other user have a user ID 4. I don't know who is user ID 4. Let me check. User 4 is demo. So login with demo. Go to my account. My other. Okay, pending shipped cancelled. Okay, track order is shipped. Now check any other pending. Track order is pending. So here is your order status. One more thing. Yeah, inside the admin I already have this covered by default values. Admin, go to orders. Okay, no, I mean admin slash orders. Okay, here is the order. Now open your my account. Okay, my account and order. Here you have two order, one is pending, second also pending. So here you will change the value. This one, make it shipped. Okay, order status by ajax It's already working. You can get the file code. I'm not explaining this. I did it many times. Here you can see second one. You can say deliver. Okay, it's order status. It go to your controller function and output is I will show you controller. Here the order status, it order status has order status, the update the query. Okay, so according to this, refresh my order. Now you can see it's delivered track order as all filled with green background. Okay, that is now dynamically working. Now you can change shift to like a ditch past. Okay, refresh my order, open track order. Now you can see a second step is done. So it's say pending dispatch. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you. Open terminal, I make a new model for your orders product table. Okay, because I need both of join, like I will show you inside your route. Just make a test function. I will show what I want to do. Let's say test and here function, just simply for demo purpose, return app slash your orders. Is you can say all, it will return all of data. Okay, just put here test and it's all data, but I need combination of orders product and orders data. Okay, so for that you need to make a new model, like a PHP artisan make model. Here you will say orders products. Okay, model complete. Now go to your app. Inside the app you have a orders model. Here I created a order products function. It will connected with your new created model, which is this. This is empty, so no problem. But you can call it here with function. You can say orders products. Okay, products and get function. You can see its order and other product attached with this order. Okay, now order number 21 21 21. Okay, and order number 20 is have a two product all inside this. This way you can fetch a combination join. Okay, we will make a help. Here we can display more information about your user dashboard, user order. Okay, and here is a order detail, so we will display here help of this join. Okay, so that's it. I will show you my admin. You can get code from my GitHub, so don't worry about it. Here order, here you can see, and drop down which connected to your ajax order id passing to url is order status. So here is the order status. It will go to your route. Here you can see order status admin controller. Admin controller is admin controller. Here is the order status. Okay, just update query and update the data. So here you can see your orders. Anyone can change now. If I say my order 1 dispatch deliver, okay, so I can change here values. If I cancel this order now, here is problem because we are nothing. So for that we will say if it cancelled, so we will display something else. Let me copy this value actually, not a spelling mistake, so it will not enter manually. Okay, is cancel, so we will say for now I will say was only yes online center, your order cancel by admin, that's it. Your order cancel by admin. Okay, by default is pending status, so I will show you by shopping. And new thing is thank you page. I already added thank you page. Okay, checkout, and I display username and email ID. Okay, so here is phone number. You can change something, city, state, country, address, place order. Now it go to thank you page. Now again go to my account, my orders. It is your new order. Tag order is pending, so admin thinking new order pending, so make it dispatched. So you can check your order is now dispatched. Okay, that's it. Today's video on this old code on GitHub, just grab that code. Okay, if you have any question, any query, please put comment below. Okay, thank you.